Hello, welcome to European Open Briefing for Friday, November the 2nd. I'm Raf Boyajian, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be taking a look at what's happening in the currency markets today. So we can see there's a continuation of that risk-on sentiment. So as we head towards the end of the week, we're seeing global equities up sharply. Once again, we can see all the major indices in the green. We had another positive close on Wall Street overnight. If you look at what's happening to the US dollar, it's down sharply. Yesterday was down sharply. It's extending its declines this morning by around 0.2%. It's currently trading just above the 96 level. Dollar yen, though, is doing better after the yesterday's slide. The yen is broadly weaker this morning due to that strong recovery in risk appetite, which comes after news that President Trump has had a phone call with China's President Xi, and he later tweeted that the trade discussions with China are moving along nicely. So that has sharply reduced trade tensions, and so we're seeing big benefit for risk-sensitive currencies such as the Australian and New Zealand dollars. The Kiwi was yesterday's biggest gainer, rising by more than 2%. It's now extending its gains to 0.6663 against the US dollar. The Aussie also doing rather nicely. We also did have some fairly positive data out of Australia. The Aussie has broken about the 0.72 level to climb to around 0.7233 dollars. If you look at European currencies, sterling was the second best performer yesterday, following those positive Brexit headlines and a somewhat more hawkish Bank of England than had been anticipated at the policy meeting yesterday. Sterling breaking about the 1.30 level and currently up by around 0.1%. Euro is also benefiting from that weaker US dollar, rising back above the 1.14 dollar level. The Canadian dollar, although it is up this morning at around 1.3054 to the US dollar, it has been somewhat underperforming, mainly due to weaker oil prices. Oil prices are down once again this morning. WTI falling by 0.4% to $63.43 a barrel. So we had those reports of higher OPEC output during October, and now we're seeing further indications that the US will give some countries waivers to continue buying Iranian crude oil once those sanctions kick in at the start of next week, in order to give them more time to find alternative suppliers. Gold is up slightly this morning on the back of a weaker US dollar. And looking at the main performance, we can see Aussie once again near or at the top of the table. Euro yen also up sharply this morning. At the bottom, we've got dollar loonie and oil prices. Looking at the dollar index now more closely, we can see there's been a significant retracement of the October gains for the dollar index, having earlier this week touched a 16-month high. It's now fallen to just above 96 level. Dollar yen doing somewhat better. Earlier, it did briefly break above the 113 level. So the yen is seeing easing of safe haven demand following that those developments with regards to US-China trading relations. So President Trump is now a bit more optimistic about having a deal with China. He says that China does want to make a fair trade deal, and China also responded to that phone call saying that it was a quite positive discussions. And we're seeing some Bloomberg reports saying that President Trump has asked his cabinet to prepare a draft trade deal. So we do have that meeting being planned for during the G20 summit towards the end of November between President Trump and President Xi. If there is some progress there, that would further boost markets. On the other hand, if there is no development there, positive development there, we could see the US president announcing new tariffs at the beginning of December. Next in focus, though, immediate focus for the US dollar today will be those non-farm payrolls numbers later in the US session for October. Let's see now what happened to sterling yesterday. We can see that sharp gains for cable. It's now trading above the $1.30 level at that's a 10-day high. So yesterday, yesterday we had that report that the UK and the EU have reached a deal on financial services, though that was later, those reports were later played down by both the UK and EU officials. Nevertheless, markets are a bit more optimistic now for a Brexit deal. There was also a report by the Financial Times that the EU is working on a compromise solution to the Irish backstop issue. And we also had the Bank of England policy meeting where Mark Carney said that a no deal, no transition Brexit is not the most likely scenario. So that again was perceived positively by the markets. And also the Bank of England did hint that UK interest rates may need to go up faster if there is a smooth Brexit, given a possible boost to the UK economy from the UK budget that was announced earlier this week. And finally, taking a quick look at the Aussie and the Kiwi, we can see both have surged over the past day. We did see some strong trade numbers and producer prices out of Australia over the past couple of days, but the main effect is from that risk on sentiment. There's also possibly some short covering as well due to both pairs being oversold over the past month. So we can see both pairs are performing at the moment. And finally, looking at what's coming up later today, we do have the final PMIs coming up out of the Eurozone, but the main focus will be on US payroll numbers as well as the Canadian employment report as well. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.